Dear students, I welcome you for the today's lecture related to the boiling. Now, basically, the boiling is a process and in which the necessity that the temperature of the fluid that should be at a saturation temperature. That is, the boiling occurs at the solid-liquid interface. Where it occurs? It occurs at the solid and liquid interface. It's a contact between a solid which is coming in contact, the liquid which is coming in contact with this hot surface or the solid surface. There only boiling occurs. Is solid hot surface pe boiling hota hai. And it is what we call when the bubbles, we see bubbles at the top of the surface, liquid surface, then we call it a boiling. No, it occurs at the hot surface. There is a boiling. So the boiling occurs at the solid-liquid interface when the liquid is brought into contact with a surface maintained at a temperature sufficiently above the saturation temperature of the liquid. There is a difference between the temperature of the solid and the temperature of the liquid. The temperature of the solid, that is sufficiently above, sufficiently higher than the temperature of the, than the saturation temperature of the liquid. Saturation temperature at which the liquid that is going to boil. When the vapor pressure is equal to the saturation pressure. That is what the process of boiling is. Basic definition of the boiling. Vapor pressure equals to the saturation pressure. So, the temperature that is sufficiently above the saturation temperature is to be maintained. Now, let us see a vessel containing a electrically heating rod. So this electrically heating rod, which is at a very high temperature than the bulk temperature of the fluid, that is what? The temperature of the heating media, temperature of the heating solid element is sufficiently high, is very high in comparison with the bulk temperature of the fluid. So, this is occurring at the solid-liquid interface. Now, similar to boiling, there is another process, that is the evaporation. Now, what is happening in case of evaporation? When we talk related to the evaporation, that process doesn't reach to the boiling point. Whenever it is reaching, fluid that reaches to the boiling point, we call the process is a boiling process. However, in the evaporation, the fluid doesn't reaches to the boiling point. That means it is a surface phenomena. It occurs at the liquid vapor interface. Jahan pe liquid aur vapor ka interface hai, there the evaporation occurs. And when the vapor pressure is less than the saturation pressure of the liquid at a given temperature, when the vapor pressure that is less than the saturation pressure of the liquid at a given temperature, then the evaporation occurs. That means if we keep a water, say at 70 degrees Celsius water temperature and surrounding temperature is say around 25 degrees Celsius. So the process of evaporation that is occurring when temperature difference is there. But however, the fluid temperature, liquid temperature that is not up to the boiling point. That is a major difference between the evaporation and the boiling. In the process of evaporation, vapor pressure is less than the saturation pressure. and it's a surface phenomena where from liquid phase to the vapor phase it is going. However, in case of a boiling, it is a solid surface which is at a sufficiently higher temperature than the bulk liquid. There, the process or the bubbles, they are occurring, or bubbles, they are forming. Similarly, in case of kettle also. In the kettle, we are having a special space, vapor space that is provided. That is why we call it a kettle. This vapor space allows the vapors to hold in the vessel so that the liquid that will remain at a higher temperature for a longer time. So, a liquid to the vapor phase change process is called the evaporation if it is originated at the liquid vapor interface. That is the major difference between the boiling and the process of evaporation. Now we are focused to the boiling. So we will, boiling is a convection. This convection process is taking place into the boiling. That is, boiling is a convective heat transfer process with a phase change from liquid to the vapor. Here the heat is supplied to the liquid through the heated surface maintained at a temperature above the saturation temperature of the liquid. So where these processes they are occurring, the steam production, that is the major application of this boiling is required. Steam production, then your absorption of heat in refrigeration system, then concentration in evaporators, then distillation columns or reboilers. In the distillation column, reboilers, they are attached. Then spacecraft and rockets. These are the different applications of this boiling process. Now, it's a convective process. So, basic convective heat transfer coefficient or heat transfer equation that will be required. So, that is Q boiling, which is H into the temperature difference. TS is the wall temperature and T saturated is the bulk liquid temperature. So, this is Q boiling, that is units having watt per meter square, capital Q upon A. Now, coming to the classification of the boiling. That is, first is classification of boiling on the basis of presence of bulk fluid motion. How or what is the fluid motion? Based on that, the classification has been done. That is one of the ways to classify the process of boiling. And second process is, that is based on the presence of bulk liquid temperature. It is the bulk liquid temperature that is there. So one by one we will see the classification of boiling, that is based on the bulk motion. What is the motion? In the process of convection, we are having the natural convection and forced convection. That is based on the fluid is getting naturally movement, or the fluid is forced movement. So, similar to that, here in the process of the boiling, because of the bulk motion of the fluid, this is classified. One is called the pool boiling and second is called the flow boiling. This flow boiling, that is also called the force boiling also. Force boiling or the flow boiling. And pool boiling, that is similar to the natural convection processes. So boiling is called the pool boiling in the absence of the bulk fluid flow. Now what is happening in case of a pool boiling? A certain vessel that is available. The liquid which is poured into a vessel. So this vessel containing a liquid which is not being agitated, which is no external source of energy that is used for mixing purpose in case of a pool boiling. It is hold and is the fluid is in a stable condition. Now, when it is heated to a certain temperature, the internal movement of the fluid that starts, the internal fluid movement, microscopic fluid movement that starts. That is because of the natural convection and because of the temperature difference, the density difference occurs. As a result, the fluid motion is created inside this pot. That is the pool boiling. So any motion of the fluid is due to the natural convective currents and the motion of the bubble under the influence of buoyancy. This motion of the bubbles, that is because of the buoyant forces. So this is the natural convection and the motion of the bubbles is because of the buoyancy forces. That is in case of a pool boiling. Now the flow boiling. The word itself talks, the flow boiling is the bulk fluid motion. The fluid that is moving. That is why it is called the flow boiling. It is this flow boiling is also called as the force boiling also. In the flow boiling, the fluid is forced to move in a heated pipe or a surface by external means such as the pump. So this is a vertical tube that is shown. It can be inclined tube or it can be the horizontal tube also, or sometimes it can be in a vessel also where the fluid that is moving because of the agitation process, that is also the different stage. So this is the flow boiling in which the bulk fluid movement that is observed. So this is the classification based on the fluid motion. One is pool boiling, second is the flow boiling. This is classification based on the fluid motion. Then second classification, that is on the basis of the presence of the bulk liquid temperature. Bulk liquid temperature. What is the liquid temperature? Now there are two vessels in which the heating is, that is at a 107 degree Celsius in both the figures. However, the temperature is 80 degree Celsius and the temperature is 100 degree Celsius. That is at a saturation temperature. This is considered to be at one atmospheric pressure. So 100 degree Celsius is your saturation temperature at one atmospheric pressure. So depending on this temperature, that is what the basis of the presence of bulk liquid temperature. That is, if the temperature that is less than the saturation temperature, then it is called a subcooled boiling or the local boiling. Subcooled boiling or the local boiling. And the second, where the bulk fluid temperature is at a saturation temperature, it is called a saturation boiling or the bulk boiling. So these two types of the boiling based on the bulk liquid temperature. Now, when the temperature of the main body of the liquid is below the saturation temperature, main body of the liquid that is below the saturation temperature, the generated bubbles from the hot metal surface immediately collapse at the metal surface. This is what the phenomena which is getting happened, and one should be able to observe this phenomena. That is, bubbles are formed. However, these bubbles could not reach up to the top because the bulk temperature of the fluid is less than the saturation temperature, is less than the boiling point of the liquid. So these bubbles, they get disappear. They could not reach to the top surface. They could not reach to the top surface. They get disappeared because of their less energy, or you can say the surrounding or the bulk fluid which is getting energy from these bubbles, and that increases the temperature of this bulk fluid. So these vapor bubbles generated at the hot metal surface immediately collapse at the metal surface or just after leaving the surface. That depends on the bulk temperature. Immediately on the surface it should disappear, or it should disappear inside the liquid pool. That depends on the bulk temperature of the surrounding. So vapor bubbles do not reach at the top surface. That is what is happened in case of the subcooled boiling or the local boiling. And second is the saturated bulk boiling, when the temperature of the liquid is equal to the saturation temperature. That is called a saturated or the bulk boiling. So these two classifications, one is based on the flow motion and second based on the presence of the bulk liquid temperature. Now out of this, the full boiling is more happening process. Even flow boiling, that is also there in case of your steam production processes, it's a flow boiling that is getting observed. Now coming to the full boiling, we'll see the step by step process of the full boiling. Full boiling, that is taking place where the fluid that is stationary, fluid is not forced or is not agitated with the help of the other means, other energy sources. So in the full boiling, the fluid is not forced to flow by a mover such as the pump or agitator. Any motion of the fluid is due to the natural convection currents and the motion of the bubbles under the influence of the buoyancy. This is the, both the processes are taking in a natural form. That is the natural convection. As I am going to heat the fluid which is just in contact with this surface which is higher temperature, that fluid is getting heated, and the heated fluid that moves in the upward direction because of the less density, and the fluid which is at a higher density that moves in a downward direction because of the lower temperature. Now this cycle that continues, and the convective currents they are developed inside the vessel. So this convective current leads to the natural circulation in the pool boiling. So these are your natural convective currents, natural convection currents, and this is the process, that is natural convection boiling. Then there is a nucleate boiling that is taking place, where the bubbles they are formed. One bubble, second bubble, on this surface which is at a higher temperature. the surface of the solid is higher temperature than the bulk, than the saturation temperature. 100 degrees Celsius is your boiling point, and the surface temperature is higher than the 100 degrees Celsius. The next, there is a transition of the boiling. The bubbles which are formed at this surface, 2-3 small bubbles, they get coagulated. They get and form a bigger size bubbles. And the bigger size bubbles, as we increase the temperature, these bigger size bubbles, they form a continuous film as shown in this figure. So that is called the film boiling. So it's a stepwise process. Natural convection first, then the nucleate boiling, that means bubbles they are formed, then these small bubbles they get coagulated and forms a bigger size bubbles, that is what a transition boiling, and these bigger size bubbles form a continuous layer or continuous bubble film over the solid surface. This is what a continuous bubble film, that is formed over the solid surface. So this is called the film boiling, a continuous film that is formed over this surface. So this is the boiling regimes. Now one by one, we'll see this boiling regime in a pool boiling process. So that is the natural convection boiling first, then second that is the nucleate boiling, third that is the transition boiling, fourth that is the film boiling. That is what we have mentioned here. Natural convection, the nucleate boiling, the transition boiling, and the film boiling. So this is a graph that is plotted against watt per meter square, that is the heat flux, against the temperature difference, TS minus T saturated. Now what is TS? TS is the surface temperature, solid temperature, and TS, that is T saturated, is your boiling point temperature. So initially this is say at 103 degrees Celsius and T saturated, that is there 100 degrees Celsius. Every time T saturated is your fixed 100 degrees Celsius. However, this solid surface will increase its temperature. Initially that will be at a lower temperature, then its temperature, that is, increased to 110 degrees Celsius, then to the 200 degrees Celsius, and then to the 400 degrees Celsius. So depending on this, now the temperature difference that is going to take place. So only 2 to 3 degrees temperature difference that is there. Here the temperature difference is 5 to 10 degrees Celsius. Here the temperature is 100 to 200 degrees Celsius. And here that is more than 200 degrees Celsius temperature difference that is observed. So there is a natural convection boiling, the nucleate boiling, transition boiling, and the film boiling. These are the four different regimes that is observed in the pool boiling process. This is a typical boiling curve for the water at 1 atmospheric pressure that is plotted against the heat flux Q in watt per meter square against the excess temperature T wall minus T saturated. So what is happening in case of natural convection? Naturally, circulation currents, they are developed. The fluid which is just near to the surface of the solid wall is getting heated. That fluid particles moves to the top because of the lower density. As the density of the upper fluid, which is having the lower temperature, so that is higher. So and their density is high, so they move in the downward direction and the process continues. Then there is a nuclear bubbles. This surface temperature that is increased slightly from 103 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. Now, as the temperature of the surface that is increased, so temperature difference, that is the wall temperature minus T saturation, that is also increased. So that reaches to the 2 to 5 degrees Celsius, 2 to 10 degrees Celsius in this case. And one can observe the temperature difference. So bubbles collapse inside the liquid. Nucleus that is formed, bubbles that is formed. Nuclear boiling, that means the small bubbles they are formed in case of your nucleate boiling. At the surface, at the metal surface, the small bubbles they are formed. If you have observed the process of the boiling, then the small bubbles which are forming at the surface, and these bubbles at the point where the bubbles they start forming, that is the nuclear boiling regime, one is reached or the temperature is reached to this nuclear boiling regime where the bubble formation starts. But these bubbles, they get collapsed into the liquid first. As we have seen in the process, the bubbles, they get collapsed or they get disappeared into the liquid itself. So this first region here in this nuclear boiling, there are two regions are observed. The region 1 and region 2. So this is the region, in this region where the bubbles they are formed, but they get disappeared into the fluid. Then the bubbles rise to the free surface. That is the second situation. Bubbles rise up to the surface. In this region, the bubbles, they are generated, but they get disappeared into the liquid. So in process of in the regime of nuclear boiling, two steps are observed. One, where the bubbles get disappeared into the fluid, and second, the bubbles rise to the free surface. Bubbles rise to the free surface. Here the bubbles, they are rising to the free surface. Then what happens to the heat transfer coefficient? The amount of the heat transfer. Initially, the temperature difference, that is low. So here the heat transfer, that is also of the lower, that is of the order of 150 kilowatt per meter cube. Heat transfer is in the range of 150 kilowatt per meter cube, per meter square, sorry. Then there is a difference in the slope in this region of nucleate boiling. In the natural convection boiling, the slope is less. However, in the nuclear boiling, the slope of the heat flux, that is higher. And it reaches the maximum heat flux. That is the maximum heat flux, that is called a critical heat flux. So, in the process of nuclear boiling, where the rapid heat exchange that is observed. Why this rapid heat transfer? Because of the movement of the bubbles, the bubbles generated, they leave the surface and goes into the bulk of the liquid. That is what the bubble movement, and this bubble movement leads to the agitation, physical movement into the bulk of the liquid, that is observed in case of this nuclear boiling regime. Physical movement, bubbles move, bubble detached from the surface of the solid that moves inside the bulk fluid, whether it gets disappeared or whether it reaches to the surface. So this is the bubble collapse in the liquid or bubbles rises to the surface. But the generated bubbles, they create a turbulence inside the pool. So this generated turbulence that increases the heat flux. In the first natural convection, there is only natural circulation that is taking place. Natural movement because of the density difference, because of the thermocycling process, and that is why the heat flux is less, then the bubble formation proceeds, so the heat flux increases and reaches to a critical value that is called a critical heat flux. So this critical heat flux is having the value of 3150 kilowatt per meter square. Then next is transition regime, the transition boiling regime, where the generated bubbles, generated small bubbles, small 2-3 bubbles, they form a bigger size bubble. But the bubbles are there. Bigger size bubbles which are formed because of the collapsing of the smaller bubbles. Smaller 2-3-4 bubbles, they get collected to form a one bigger size bubble. That is what is happening in case of a transition boiling. So the heat transfer, heat flux that goes on reducing, because whatever the small bubbles, they are getting churned or forming a churning and increasing the turbulence, that is reduced, so that the generated heat flux that reduces. Sometimes this transition boiling that also comes into the category of the film boiling. Sometimes different, that depends on book to book. Some books also define only the three regimes. A film boiling regime includes the transition boiling also. Film boiling regime includes the transition regime. The generated small bubbles, generated bigger bubbles from the coalescence of the smaller bubble. Smaller bubbles, they get coalescence. Those in small bubbles, they get coalescence to form a bigger bubble. And then these bigger bubbles, they again get coalescence to form a liquid film. So whenever there is a complete generation of a liquid film, that is the heat transfer is reduced. And that is why the lowest, there is a decrease in the heat transfer. Heat flux, decrease in the heat flux that is observed is because of this film that is getting formed. Yahan pe choti film hai aur yahan pe badi film create generate ho gayi, complete surface pe film generate ho gayi, and that is why your heat flux that reduces. So the heat flux causes begin to rise because of the radiant heat flux, then it becomes this stable film boiling. Then after that, it's a radiation regime that is observed. Means in addition to this convection, radiation regime that is also observed. So heat transfer because of the radiation that is also added to this process. So one by one we'll again reading. Then the natural convection boiling, that is from point A. This is the region of natural convection. The bubbles do not form on heating surface until the liquid is heated a few degrees above the saturation temperature. The liquid is slightly superheated in this case. The fluid motion in this mode of boiling is governed by the natural convection, natural circulation, natural current. They are only responsible for the fluid movement. Then the heat transfer from the heating surface to the fluid is by the natural convection. Natural convection boiling ends at an excess temperature of about 5 degrees Celsius. The temperature difference is around 5 degrees Celsius. 5 degrees Celsius ka temperature difference hai. Wahan pe natural convection stop ho jata hai. Then your nucleate boiling that starts. Now in this figure you can observe the nucleate boiling. Small bubbles they are formed on the surface. And this is what? Nucleate boiling, this region, that is the nucleate boiling region. That is the bubbles form at an increasing rate. At an increasing rate with the heat flux. Increasing number of nucleate sites as we move along the boiling curve towards the C. From A to C, you can observe this nucleate boiling phenomena. Now the region A to B, isolated bubbles. Here the temperature difference is in between the 5 to 10 degrees Celsius, and where the bubbles collapse in the liquid itself. Bubbles, they get collapsed in this region. Then bubbles rise up to the top surface, where the temperature difference is from 10 to 30 degrees Celsius. This point A, that is referred to as the onset of nucleate boiling. This point A, that is called the onset of nucleate boiling. From there, the nucleate boiling, that is starting. The slope of this heat flux, that is also changing at this point. Then region A to B, the studding and agitation caused by the entrainment of the liquid to the heater surface is primarily responsible for increasing the heat transfer. Whatever the bubbles get detached and they move, so this is causing the circulation, causing the turbulence and increasing the heat flux. In the region A to B, the larger heat flux in B to C, the larger heat flux obtained in the region are caused by the combined effect of liquid entrainment and evaporation. For the entire nucleate boiling ranges, the heat transfer coefficient ranges from 2000 to 30,000 watt per meter square Kelvin. Then after the point B, the heat flux increases at a lower rate with the increasing temperature difference and reaches a maximum at the point C. This is called the maximum critical heat flux. So this is the heat flux at this point is called the critical or the maximum heat flux and is of prime engineering importance. Then the region C to D, that is the film boiling or the transition boiling also, where the larger size pockets, larger size bubbles they are formed. When the temperature difference increases past the C, the heat flux decreases. The heat flux decreases. We can see the graph. The heat flux decreases because of the formation of this film. Film reduces this heat transfer flux. So this is because a large fraction of the heater surface is covered by a vapor film, which acts as an insulation. And that is why this heat flux that decreases in the transition boiling regime, both nucleate and film boiling rapidly occurs. The operation in this transition boiling regime, which is also called the unstable film boiling regime, is also called the unstable film boiling regime. That means your film formation is more or less observed from transition boiling itself, but the generated film is unstable in this transition regime. That is why some authors, they have distinguished this transition boiling and film boiling, or sometimes they have clubbed it, the transition boiling and film boiling, that is clubbed sometimes. Then the flow water transition boiling occurs over the excess of temperature range from about say 30 degrees Celsius to 120 degrees Celsius. Then the beyond the point D, again the heat flux that increases. The heater surface is completely covered by a continuous vapor film, where the heat flux reaches a minimum is called the Liudec frost point. The presence of vapor film between the heater surface and the liquid is responsible for low heat transfer rates in the liquid film boiling regime. The heat transfer rate increases with the increasing excess temperature due to the radiation to the liquid. After that, your radiation that becomes common. Then there is a burnt out point or the excess maximum point C. This C point that is also called the burnt out heat point. A typical boiling process does not follow the boiling curve beyond the point C, but up to point C that is observed. After point C, there can be the how this liquid film that is formed that depends on the surface, that depends on the fluid, surface tension, the different properties. And that is why this C to D, there is a slight difference that can be observed. A typical boiling process does not follow the boiling curve beyond the point C. When the power applied to the heated surface exceeded the value at point C, even slightly, the surface temperature increases suddenly at to the point E. This path that can also be accepted. Sudden jump in the temperature that can be also accepted. Bypass parts of the boiling curve that is there, and this is sudden drop in the temperature that can be also observed. So when the power that is reduced gradually starting from the point E, the cooling curve follows with a sudden drop in the excess temperature when the point D that is reached. Any attempt to increase the heat flux beyond the Q maximum will cause the operation point on the boiling curve to jump suddenly from point C to the point E. However, the surface temperature that corresponds to the point E beyond the melting point of most heater materials, and that is why it is the burnt out occurs. If this temperature is the material metal temperature is beyond the melting point, then that metal can get affected, and where the accident that can happen is because of the burnt out occurrence. The point C on the boiling curve is also called his burnt out point, and the heat flux at this point, the burnt out heat flux. The most boiling heat transfer equipments in practical operations slightly below the Q maximum to avoid any disastrous burnt outs. So that is why by selecting the material for the boiling processes, one has to be cautious to this burnt out point. Then coming to the heat transfer coefficients. Now, the natural convection regime, nuclear boiling, then the film boiling, all these are having the different correlations. The boiling regime differs considerably in their characteristics. Then the different heat transfer relations needed to be used for the different boiling regimes. So in the natural convection boiling regime, heat transfer rate can be accurately determined using the natural convection relation, that is what Q, which is equal to H A delta T. Then nuclear boiling, no general theoretical relation for heat transfer in this nuclear boiling regime that is observed. So experimental based correlations are used. And the rate of heat transfer strongly dependent on the nature of nucleation and the type of the condition of the heated surface and the type of the fluid that is also going to affect this process of nuclear boiling. So this is the correlation that is proposed by Rowan Snow, and that is incorporating the viscosity lambda, then density difference, surface tension. So all these different factors that is incorporated for this nucleate boiling process. Then the maximum of the critical heat flux, therefore Q maximum, that is also calculated by C critical and is a constant value depending on the heater geometry, but generally is about 0.15. Then lambda, sigma, surface tension, gravity, density, then density difference, or raised to the 1/4. Then the maximum heat flux that is there, the which occurs at the minimum heat flux, which occurs at this Lindenstrasse point. It's a practical interest since it is responsible the lower limit for the heat flux in the film boiling regime. So this is what general experimental correlation that corresponding to this heat flux, minimum heat flux. Then the film boiling. In case of film boiling, you are going to use this correlation, where the C film, that is depending on 0.62 for the horizontal cylinder and 0.67 for spheres.